Hi everyone, my name is David, and I'm a musician, and I'm making an album here in the next 30 days. And I haven't made a video in the last 6 days because I've been sick as a dog. And I don't know why they use that expression, because I don't think the dogs are a particularly sickly animal, but I have been personally a little bit under the weather. And it's been tough because I have had a hard time singing. And also, there's a bunch of junk in here, and I'm sensitive to light. That's why I'm wearing the shades. Actually, I'm wearing them to look cool. But the important thing is that I've continued to make music and make progress towards my album, which is scheduled for release on May 19th. So I'll leave a link to that in the description, the Spotify or whatever, when it comes out or when it's available for pre-order or so check down there. And I'm doing all my sequencing in Cubase. So because I was unable to sing with a few days ago it was terrible. I had to use Autotune, and I've done a tutorial on this before, and I'll put a thing like in one of these corners about that where I explain this process in more detail. But I didn't use Vary Audio, which is Cubase's built-in pitch correction. What I used was a plugin or an insert in Cubase called Pitch Correct. So let's just jump into the project right here, and I'll show you guys. My issue was just like not like I sounded like 100 miles of rough road. So let's hear this computer. Give me a beat. And here in the first part,
Something like that.
I'm just sort of doing my intro rap type thing. I say like,
my name is DJ David C. Harper, and I'm about to say something really, really cool, so everybody quiet down. Here we go. I'm like bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm saying bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm like bleep.
So you get the idea, and I want to show you what I did here on both of these chorus and Robot Vox. You'll see these two track names. We can take a look at the inserts. This one I have some EQ tone shaping, and then the pitch correct. And of course, on the pitch correct, I had the external setup as the scale source MIDI note. And you'll see the same setting on the Robot Vox. And the Robot Vox, I have the amp rack, and I added, I think, some modulation like a flanger to make it so we can solo the robot voice.
Blah, bleep, blah, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm singing bleep, blah, bleep, blah, bloop.
Oh, but I have to solo it with the MIDI to get the pitch correction.
Bleep, blah, bleep, blah, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm singing bleep, blah, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute.
And if we bypass those, this is what the original track sounded like.
Bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm saying bleep.
So I actually had a voice, but I couldn't hit any notes or anything. So together, what I did here is when you have a MIDI track, and if you look at the routing of this MIDI track, I can pull up the mixer, actually, it might be easier. Here's the Robot Vox MIDI. Let me just make this bigger. If you hit H, you can make your tracks bigger. So this is being routed in to pitch correct MIDI in. So that's where I want it. And this is being routed to pitch correct MIDI in on the chorus track. So these MIDI tracks correspond with these audio tracks. And that's how this pitch correct plugin works. This chorus MIDI, I'll take these solos off. Or let's just solo the chorus and the robot MIDI so you can hear what's going on.
Like bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm saying bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute.
So what I did here is on the robot vocals, which has more effects. It has the flanger and it has, I think, chorus and a little bit other modulation. I have, a melody line playing na 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 na. So I was able to write a melody, but that would sound sort of weird. So what I did is I doubled the track here in the chorus, and then my chorus MIDI is just a straight G, which is the key of the song. So it's sort of like a drone note. So one will be like bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute, and the other one will be more of a melodic type thing. So together you get this.
I'm like bleep, blop, bloop.
Computers making music with my Indian flute. I'm saying bleep, blop, bleep, blop, bloop. Computers making music with my Indian flute.
So that's my Indian flute song. At the end here also, you can trill stuff out. And as you can see, like, this MIDI's all over the place. And it's like...
The robots are coming, the robots are coming, the robots are coming, the robots are here.
So you get something like that where you have this, you know, they're shifting octaves here on the MIDI. Like, I make it bigger so you can actually see it. That would be a good idea. You know, I'm doing some this octave stuff. And it creates this type of effect.
The robots are coming, the robots are coming, the robots are coming, the robots are...
And it's the same track, just duplicated, obviously. And that is auto-tuning. And if you want more information on auto-tuning, I would suggest that you check out the video where I explain this method in much more detail. And that is one thing that I did during my illness. And the other thing was I shred guitars. On this song that I wrote called Fugue States, which I also don't have lyrics for, but let's check that out right now. Okay, so you saw me play, and I hope you enjoyed it, but what I really want to get at is, you know, you saw those changes while I was playing, and it was like almost as if by magic. It's not like I have a pedal board at my feet or anything, but what I did was, here, I used these tracks, and I used Guitar Rig, so let's open up Guitar Rig, and what I did was automate the use of distortion on these tracks. So I use Guitar Rig for both tracks, and we'll listen through and just take a look at the distortions at least, but this reflector. So when we go from one part to the next, these will turn on. And as we go from one part to the next, you'll see the reflector will turn off. This will turn off. So it's not magic, it's automation, and I'll try to show you all what's going on here. In this clean part, I have the distortion off, and this is reflector on off. And then this one down here should be STO. What is that? Oh, that's the stoned phaser. So I have the stone phaser and the reflector on during the clean part, and they cut off during the hard part. So you'll see at these lines right here, this is where I've drawn in the change. It's like you have a stomp box and you're stomping off your reverb and phaser pedals and stomping on your distortion pedal. So watch these turn from off to on as it hits this blue line here. Pretty cool, huh? That's how I did that type of automation. And there's one more thing I wanted to show you guys, because today's episode is called Autotune, Automation, and Iteration. When you're recording and you're doing a lot of different versions and you're trying things and you're being experimental, you are definitely at times going to make some serious mistakes. And the best way to keep track of that or be able to revert is to do version control. So I have a notepad here and I take notes of where I'm at before I pull this little maneuver. Now everybody knows Control S saves, but I want to key you into something that's really cool in Cubase. If you name your project, and you'll see it right here, -01. So if I wanted to, you know, make sure it's 01, do a save as, all I have to do is hit Control Alt S. And now it becomes Fever Dreams dash 02. And that's how you can save different iterations. So if you get to a certain point, you can write all guitars tracked, Control Alt S, you track the bass. If you're going to start doing crazy stuff, adding crazy shit in the mix, you know, you can say, oh, I like the mix at this point, but I'm going to try some experimental stuff. So you hit Control Alt S and it becomes Fever Dreams slash 03 title slash. And that is a super quick way to have different iterations on your projects. So that covers the three things I wanted to talk about today. I hope you all have found this useful. Feel free to like or subscribe or leave a comment if there's something you want to see me get into specifically. And I will put the link to the album when it comes out on May 19th. I've been sick and I'm behind, but I'm ready to just knock this shit out and make some music. So I hope that you all have a great day and take care of yourselves and keep on rocking. Bye.